is like you, Lord, in all the earth.
Nobody, nobody.
Matchless love and beauty, endless war.
That's you, Lord.
Nothing in this world can satisfy.
Only you, Lord, only you.
For Jesus, you are the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me. Your presence,
Jesus,
is heaven to me.
Father, please never forsake us. What will we do that will cause you to reject us? Please help us never to do it. Continually, consistently at all times, please help us to connect with you. Thank you for this Saturday, the last day of this week. And we are praying, Lord, remember us for good today. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Friends, I'm glad again to be here. And we are closing on the topic, prepare. Today, we started on Thursday and we told us the consequences of not preparing, not ready. And today we are going to conclude on that. But I'd like to remind you, by the grace of God in our church, it will be 4 services. And the 4th service is a special service for the women. It's a special service for the women. But this evening, by 5 p.m., we'll be having a regional evangelist. Yesterday night was beautiful. I know today is going to be lovely. So you are invited 5 p.m. today. Join us. And the Lord will bless you. Also tomorrow, in any of our 4 services, 6:30 to 7:45, 9:05 to 10:15, 10:20 to 11:30. We will expect you, and we have reserved your seat, and it will not be nice for you to keep to stand us up. Praise the Lord. The Lord bless you. So today, remember our text is Luke 14:28, and it says, which man want to embark on an activity, on a project, and will not sit down to think about it, to plan about it, to prepare what he wants to do? And there's this story in Isaiah 38. The Bible recorded that the Almighty God told a man of God, Isaiah, go and tell Hezekiah is going to die. And Hezekiah looked at the prophet, God sent you, Abi. And Hezekiah went and turned his face to the wall and started praying to the Almighty God. See, God, I can't die here too. You know how I have served you. You know I love you and I want to serve you more. Brethren, what can you make as a matter before your God? God said to us, say, lay your argument before me. Hezekiah went before him and lay his argument. And God look at this argument. Say, no, you are talking. You have a say there. And God told Isaiah, hello guy, prophet, you have to go back and deliver that message again. Tell the guy, I will not only not allow you to die now, I will also add 15 years to your years. I will also prevent this city from being taken by any man. I will protect this city. Isaiah chapter 38 from verse 1 to 6. He said, why? Hezekiah has something he can table before God. I told someone some time ago, I said, when you invested in the kingdom business, when you serve God with your whole heart, and there's a matter before you, you can go before God and say, sir, look at this matter. Remember how I serve you. Remember what I've done for you. When God is looking for worshippers, he will remember those that worship him. He will not lead let them go. That's why he said not a single strand of hair your head can fall without his knowledge. In Proverbs chapter 6, from verse 6, the Bible says the ants, they always prepare for the rainy day. Go and read it as Proverbs chapter 6 from verse 6 to 8. The ants, they prepare for their own rainy day. Every man, you must prepare. There will be a day of reckoning. There will be a day that you will need to present something. Friends, I round up this day by reading from Amos chapter 4, verse 11. Let me just paraphrase it. You can go and read it. Amos 4, 11 and 12. He said, because see the way I distrust Sodom and Gomorrah. You have done badly. I'm going to deal with you too. He said in verse 12, he said, hey Israel, prepare to meet your God. Friends, God can visit you anytime. God can come anytime. Are you ready? Prepare to meet your God. God bless you. We'll see you on Monday. Have a great weekend.